We're on the cusp of some huge changes in the world of transportation after pretty much 100 years of just incremental changes right across the board. And we think that there is a real need for the design community to get involved in the discussions about the future of transportation.
We're learning new ways to think about the built environment, to think about how people move, what's the human condition, what is it going to be potentially in the future, and how we can adapt our transportation systems to actually match that.
We really think about how different stakeholders work together, not really for business, but how from a conceptual or like utopian kind of thinking process. Then we also down to earth, we think about how things can actually work with all different parts and involved with it to providing a better transportation system for delivering people and delivering stuff, point A to B.
Systems can be something as simple as like the way that you go tap your card into the Gold Line. Simultaneously, systems can be as big as literally global. So everybody touches on hot things like automation, but seriously, if you're going to create infrastructures and networks that are going to work for people and going to work for those societies, you're going to have them talk to each other.
We're looking for a complete story. They have to show that they've identified an issue that needs solving and that they come up with a complete package, which they could then take into the real world and hope to persuade people that it's worth doing. We expect a lot of teamwork amongst the students. We help them understand how you can actually create a much better solution when several people have input.
We come from a number of backgrounds, environmental engineering, product design, graphic design, mechanical engineering. But we have a lot of feedback from them, and it's great because you get so many sides to the story, which normally we just wouldn't.
They're all striving for things that are really interesting and great. It's that willingness to be flexible, get into deep research with yourself, and simultaneously have broad skills that will aid everybody around you.
We want to create change. If we just teach them what is necessary to get a career currently, then in 15 years, they'll be out of date. What we really need to do is we need to educate our students on where the world is going or where we think the world is going to go.
There were no jobs which there are today in Silicon Valley 10, 15 years ago. And I believe in the car companies happens exactly the same thing. And students today, after graduation, might need to create their own jobs.
We are seeing a huge explosion in change. I would say open your mind to understand where design is going, not just in the near future, but even further down the road, 50 years, 100 years.
And we're moving into some challenges in the next few decades that are going to demand a new kind of contributor. And so that's our goal, is to prepare people for the exciting challenges that are facing us as you broadly look at transportation on this planet.
We've had a tendency to throw technology at everything as a solution. And we're living with some of those repercussions today. So I'd like our students to be able to really think these things very carefully so that in the future, they'll be able to have a sense of confidence to make decisions and to do designing that is for a better, sustainable future.
We do like to bring students into the program who have thought leadership, a fascination for transportation, passion, and a real understanding that the future is never going to be the same as the past.